Judges, are you ready? Audience, you guys ready? Ready for the Dragon Challenge? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first project, Project Fusion, Amisha Chandra and Zainab Amani, Legacy Magnet Academy.
Hi everyone, my name is Amisha Chandra.
And my name is Zainab Himani.
And we are 11th graders from Legacy Magnet Academy.
We created Project Fusion.
Growing up as teenagers in 2022, most of our lives were influenced by the things that we saw online. Society standards, stereotypes, and the media all impact us in ways that make us change the way we view ourselves and others.
As social media becomes more prominent in our lives, certain standards intervene with our way of being. Especially over the course of the pandemic, Amisha and I both felt the effects of this. We were holding ourselves to a certain standard of health that really wasn't healthy at all.
I'm sure we've all been told this at least once in our lives. Don't believe everything you see on the internet.
Unfortunately, it's not as easy as it seems.
Being misinformed by the things that we hear and see on the media prompts us to be closed-minded in regards to what we eat, how we act, how we look like, and even the things that we enjoy.
The both of us struggle with body image issues for a period of our lives, so we turned to the internet to look for answers and advice as to how we could change ourselves.
But everything we ended up finding was either misleading, harmful, or simply not true. And after making a few connections, we realized that a lot of other people feel the same way.
During our first Project Fusion launch, we asked our participants to tell us one way the media impacted the way they viewed themselves. This is what Bella said. I felt like I needed a flat stomach to be pretty.
Now this sentiment and many others can be really harmful to young minds. Not to mention that it is constantly stressed online and in our culture.
Only then did we realize the scope of the issue and began to dig deeper. We found out that mental health disorders are the number one cause for disability worldwide, and around two-thirds of people who have those mental disabilities go untreated.
This is mainly due to the lack of health education and resources in our homes, schools, and environment, which is why we created
Project Fusion.
Our goal is to redefine wellness through education and community.
Project Fusion aims to reevaluate what true well-being means by providing kids and teens with a proper education on mental, physical, and nutritional health, breaking down myths on health ideals, and by creating a safe space.
But it wasn't always this way. Initially, Project Fusion started out as an initiative for mental and physical health only for teenage girls. We heavily relied on guest speakers to deliver information, and we had minimal one-on-one interaction with our participants.
Although our first camp was a success, we weren't fond of the formatting and decided to make a few changes. We made our project inclusive to all genders and younger age groups, as well as including more topics in our curriculum and creating a closer knit community.
After all, everyone is subject to misinformation through the media, and we wanted to cover all of our bases. We crafted a week-long curriculum where we taught about a new topic each day and went through fun and interactive activities with the kids.
Day one was mental health. We defined what mental health was, identified personal stressors that they faced, and how to overcome them through engaging activities and exercises.
Day two was about physical health. Here we talked about the importance of physical activity and how specific exercises have different benefits on different parts of your body. We also stress the importance between a mind and body connection and how mental and physical health go hand in hand.
Day three was all about nutrition. We talked about what a calorie was, how to analyze nutritional information and what that means, as well as how to make healthy choices for your body while still allowing yourself to indulge in the things you love.
Our fourth and final day was about sleep hygiene. Usually, your parents tell you you need to go to bed early, and everyone says you need at least 7 hours of sleep. But that just goes in one ear and straight out the other, which is why we talked about the science behind sleep, and this helped our kids understand its importance. We talked about dreams and how sleep affects the rest of our bodies as well.
Throughout the summer, we held three different Project Fusion camps, each in different locations and with different sets of kids. We had 20 volunteers, 689 volunteer hours, and we directly impacted 135 people.
At each camp, we gave every student a pre and post survey, asking them to rate how well they knew how to take care of their mental health on a scale of 1 to 5. 83% of participants at the beginning of our camp voted a 2 or lower, but by the end, 100% of our participants changed their vote to a 4 or 5.
This was Camp 1, where we trained 10 high school volunteers on how to set up our event and familiarize them with our curriculum. We also invited 5 guest speakers to talk about mental, physical, and nutritional health, as well as their journeys as women in their respective fields.
This is Camp 2. We used the curriculum that we crafted to lead a week-long camp where we taught 20 kids about proper wellness and trained 5 high school volunteers. We partnered with an organization called Jamboree Housing. Camp 3 followed the same camp format as Camp 2. We taught another set of 20 kids about proper wellness, trained another set of 5 high school volunteers, and this time partnered with an organization called Grandma's House of Hope.
After receiving feedback from our event, we discovered that 98% of our participants said they learned something new about themselves.
We also found that 96% of our children said that they would use what we taught them in their everyday lives.
At the end of each event, we gave everyone a post-it note and asked them to write down something they took away from the day. The following includes 3 quotes, one of them being, "Rejection is opportunity for redirection." And remember, Bella, this is what you told us at the end of our camp.
"I don't think health can be measured using one standard. Everyone is different, so it's important, so learning about health in a positive, open-ended light is really helpful.
We don't realize how dangerous health misinformation can be on our daily lives. But seeing Bella improve over the course of our camp made us understand how much even a little bit of information can benefit someone."
So about our next steps, we have boiled it down to 3 main goals: curriculum, access, and outreach. To begin with, curriculum. We want to expand our curriculum to include more topics such as time management, dental hygiene, and exploring other cultures. And after working with so many younger kids, we have realized how important games are when it comes to learning, which is why we want to use our curriculum and turn it into a fun and interactive game that the children will love.
In order to make an even longer lasting impact, we want to transfer our curriculum online by creating animated videos. These animated videos would be published to our social media and YouTube channels, making them available to the public.
We want to transcend socioeconomic barriers by creating more camps in low-income areas where we can serve and educate more students that need exposure on these topics.
We would love to charter Project Fusion for high schools near our area. We already have students from Huntington Beach High School, Oxford Preparatory Academy, and Fairmont who want to start Project Fusion clubs at their own schools.
So we would love your support to help us keep kids smiling with Project Fusion. Thank you.
This time, after each performance, we're going to have a presentation. We're going to have the judges ask the performers a question, the contestants a question.
I think I'll start. That was phenomenal. I hope your families and friends are in the audience, because they should be extraordinarily proud of what you did today, but obviously what you accomplished. Just real quick, I have one question and one suggestion. This question, and either of you can answer or both. If you look at the curriculum that you had over the camps, what was one thing that was important for you to take from that? What did you learn that stuck with you?
I think the biggest thing actually was about calories, because ever since I was younger, like, the word calories has always been kind of important to me, like something like counting calories. All those negative ideas have kind of been in my head since I was a child, and actually learning like about what they are and their true meaning, and realizing that, you know, calories aren't bad, that was one of the biggest takeaways. And even I learned that from our own curriculum, so that's what I would say it was for
me. I think for me it was sleep hygiene, because I used to not get a lot of sleep, and sometimes I still don't, but understanding what happens with sleep hygiene, and understanding, like, oh yeah, if I stay out more, if I get more vitamin D during the day, it'll be easier for me to sleep at night. And actually putting these practices, like implementing them into my life, made it easier for me, and then I was able to study more, and then I've like got better grades, and just my whole life went like up after that.
Sounds great. So the suggestion, I love the follow-up points, and I don't want to add to your work, but I think we have some college students here that probably could benefit from this program. So I'll plant that seed for you.
Thank you.
And I echo the compliments. It was a phenomenal job, and it's an area that I'm very passionate about for myself, so I'm so glad to see you do this. One question is going to be kind of a funny one, but it's like, do you appreciate your parents more? And what
yes.
they tell you to do?
Yeah. We had to do
it's
with
funny,
so
isn't
many
it?
Kids. Yeah, that we had to incentivize them with popsicles and pool parties, and they were talking, and so I have to really thank them now, because imagine what they had to deal with when, like, I was a kid.
Yeah, when my stepdaughter turned 16, I got into the habit of calling my parents once a week and apologizing for anything I might have done. So these are always good lessons to take along with you. What I'm curious about was, what was the biggest surprise for you as you work through this process? Not so much the information you learned, but what did you really see within yourself that was challenged and that you didn't know you had inside of you that you were able to learn?
I think the power to, like, actually teach someone about something, like making a difference in their life, especially like younger kids who they don't really listen to you, right? That was one of the biggest challenges we faced during this project. How do you teach such small kids about topics that they might not necessarily want to learn about? So actually getting their interest, having their attention, and getting them involved was something that was really rewarding for the both of us. And I think overall, like, realizing that we have the power to do that and teach them something was one of the biggest things.
Yeah, kind of like what you said, to tell someone about something, like, you could, like, memorize any information you want, but, like, to actually have to teach something to someone, that's mastery. So we had to learn a lot of concepts ourselves and actually, like, know what we're doing so that we could teach these kids so that they would know what they're doing too.
Critical thinking, right? It's a good thing. Congratulations on such a great job today.
Thank you. All right. Congratulations. It was really, I was so impressed with the project and with your presentation. I have two quick questions for you. One, where did Project Fusion come from? Why did you name it that?
So initially, we went over how we wanted to combine mental and physical health and wellness, and the combination of everything. We came up with the word fusion, like combining everything. And also community was one of the biggest aspects of our project. So being involved and overall coming together, that's kind of how fusion came from that.
Wonderful, thank you. And then very importantly, how many hours sleep did each of you get last night?
Actually,
you got to tell the truth.
Okay, well, we had a lot of tests today, and so,
oh.
So it wasn't that much.
All right. Well, I'm hoping tonight you get a very good night's sleep. Thank
okay,
you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you so much, Amisha and Zainab from Project Fusion. Thank you. Amazing.